You know, like I told you all, I've seen a couple of episodes and I plan to go and binge watch the rest of it. It looks like a lovely story with a clear intent of...
You better watch it,
Rudrani. I will, absolutely. With a clear intent of, you know, of showing just a story. You know, it is not trying to politically create something. It's you're trying to, through that story, tell something beautiful and message of love is being given. You know, on that note, Diya, I remember the last time we sat here among all the truth bombs that you dropped. We discussed sexism and ageism a lot that exist here in Bollywood. And you told me that how, unfortunately, after a certain age, women are not given the kind of roles that they want. You know, in films, they're certainly asked to be, you know, someone's mother or someone's this, because they have that perception that after a certain age, that's the kind of character she'll create, and they're not given enough layers. So I feel thrilled that you have received a role like this, which seems to be hope that we get more roles for women, and that continues. Ki aage bhi ja ke hum dekhenge aise aur roles mile, you know, auraton ko, and especially for actors like you. Did that thought come to your mind? That is why you waited till you got something like this, because you also wanted to say that I will not take roles that are being given to me, you know, without any consideration or even sounding a little bit sexist or ageist.
Substance. Oh, I absolutely. And I think that this is a platform that finally dispels those prejudices and those stereotypes that we've been perpetuating now for the last 15, 20 years. This never happened in the era of Vahida Rehman, Sharmila Tagore, Meena Kumari. They were married women. They worked well into their late 40s. They played leading ladies and really powerful parts. At the peaks of their careers happened from their mid-30s to their mid-40s, which also happens globally. But for some reason in the last 15, 18 years, 20 years, the idea of leading a narrative, or the kind of characters that are written to lead narratives, are either girls or are boys. In fact, I was telling somebody earlier today when we were doing another interview that even the men are playing boys, right? The men aren't playing men. So this ageism, I think, is also attached to the way we write our characters. Interestingly though, men well into their 50s play these boys, but ladies into their 30s are not allowed to play these girls. So I think the women with the nose that they say and will change this. And I think there are more filmmakers now that are becoming more conscious of the fact that they've been perpetuating the stereotype and it has to stop. But it also comes from the choices that we women are making, for all the no's we say.
No, absolutely.
I think it's changing, right?
It is changing. It definitely is changing.
Yeah. I'm sure a little more.
But it's changing because the girls have started to say no. They're refusing to be a part of that.
Yeah. As you said correctly before this also, that it has to start from
within. It has to start from us, from understanding that we can't allow this anymore. Yeah.
So while we are at this, before I move on to Mohit, I'm just going to, of course, ask another question to Diya. You know, your husband has directed this wonderful progressive, and of course your production house as well, called Mind the Malhotras, which is doing really well as well. And on that, you know, on that note, again, it's a wonderful character to give to Minnie to play, because she's playing her age and she's having fun with it, where, you know, roles like this, again, are not written for women too often. And I know recently that she unnecessarily received flack on social media, where someone pointed out that she needs to do Botox and to look younger, even though she was playing a 40-year-old. How sad it is that this is the kind of notion, and this is the kind of standards of beauty do we place for our leading ladies. And we say that, you know, either you are too Botoxed or either you're less Botoxed. What do you have to say about that?
You remember I had shared a compliment with you, which I find very baffling every time I hear it. So when people meet me, especially if they've met me after a long time or they're meeting me for the first time, they say, "Oh my God, you look just the same like you did when we saw Rehna Hai Tere Dil Mein." I don't consider it a compliment at all. Because the idea, the notion that you are beautiful only if you look as young as you did when you were 19 is what determines or defines your beauty is so messed up. And that's what then perpetuates the idea of Botox and fillers and all that other rubbish that comes with it. Of course, there are individuals who choose to do it. That's their right. And that's their choice. But there are enough women out there who choose not to use any of that. And they're equally beautiful in their own way.
No, absolutely.
No, our idea of beauty has to definitely get beyond this whole concept of being young and youthful. I think lines and age come with so much incredible experience. They're like our, you know, our warrior scars. They're beautiful. We should wear them with pride.
I completely agree. And I'm sure Minnie will be, you know, she obviously handled it really well. But I really think that characters like that need to be sort of celebrated.
Minnie is gorgeous.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Well, on that note.
Yes, of course. And I celebrate her every day. I celebrate her beauty.